They say don't judge a book by its cover, but sometimes the cover of the book is way better than the book itself. Hi guys, welcome to another edition of Sidebar Reviews, and today we are going to review the CITIZENSEYE app. This app has been trending recently, and the first time I got to hear about it was when I saw an explainer video telling us what the app was all about, and it was a very beautiful video. It was a 2D style animation and explaining the concept for which the app was useful to every Ghanaian, you know, sort of like an Anna style kind of app, you know, where everybody can be a citizen vigilante and, you know, put the government on its toes to do what it's supposed to do. And then I heard CTFM talking about it on the City Trend show, which they do on Tuesdays. And you know what that means? It means it's time for me to review another app. So I went straight to the App Store on the Google Play Store, and I also downloaded it on the iOS App Store. On the Google Play Store, it has a 4.3 star rating. The app is 14 megabytes in size, has over 1,000 downloads, and is the number one trending app in Ghana. The brief info that the developers put about the app is that you express yourself as a citizen of Ghana to the Auditor General. So I quickly headed over to the review section of the app, and there was one review which says, "Great app for all citizens to bring out their views and freely express their concerns on national issues relating to good governance." But the next review says, "The app designed by amateurs looks like a website to me with minimal features." What? So I did a deep dive into all the reviews which have been posted so far, and it was mainly positive reviews that people were giving about this app. So I couldn't wait to, you know, install, launch the app, and then see what I could contribute to my beloved country Ghana, you know, being a citizen and not a spectator. So going through the app listing again, I noticed that this app was developed not by Ghanaians, okay, because it says SA, and I guess SA means South Africa. So I installed the app, launched it, and it took a very long time to load. The interface was pretty weird. This is the first kind of loading screen of its sort that I had ever seen. Then it said syncing the app and requested permissions to access my location. That's pretty normal, because if you are reporting stuff, I'm sure the government would want to know where you are reporting from. So I allowed the location permission. So after that long waiting period, something came up which says, "CITIZENSEYE public issue reporting and rating app for the Ghana Audit Service. Use this application to rate services and report issues relating to public services in Ghana. You can also view maps and reports of local service issues and ratings. Please note, if you submit personal information through the application, which is optional, we will keep your details anonymous. This application will use data, although it will work offline. In order to submit reports and view the latest information, will require an internet connection. This app was built on behalf of the Ghana Audit Service and is supported by Dutch Fur or something of the sort. I don't know how it's pronounced. The German speaking people, where are you? Dutch Fur. Okay. International Zozemamalat. GIZ. So then there's an OK button, and then there's a more information button. But immediately I was very disappointed with the user interface. On the home screen, there are two buttons. There's a rate service and report an abuse button. So I don't know, what does each of them do? Rate a service, which kind of service, report an issue? Well, we'll go through. Then there's a maps icon that you can click, and then it shows hospital issues, education issues, environment issues, infrastructure, etc. Then there are other issues. So I quickly headed over to see what kind of other issues, and I was presented with a map of Africa. Not just a map of Africa, you could drag anywhere. And then there are pins on that map, including one at Botswana. Like, hello, this is a Ghana app, right? So what's this Botswana thing? So I clicked on it, on one of the pins located on the map, and then I could see the option to take an Uber to the location or send an email to the location. And when you click on the location details, you can see a lot of programming errors and strings and stuff like that. When you click on hospital, there's nothing. I mean, the app is weird, man. It doesn't work. It's crazy. So I click on maps, I clicked on how to, and it gives some instructions how to report an issue, how to rate a service, blah blah blah. Why should I use this app? Who made this app? Guys, I can't believe that this app was actually made by Deutsch whatever. I mean, come on, Deutsch something. Yeah, it's either South Africa or it's German, right? This doesn't look like an app from Germany. This looks like an app from my village somewhere for Mina in the Ashanti region. Where? See the graphics, red and green and white. This looks like a typical NDC Charlie app, be like that though. So next, I chose report an issue. I went to find, hospital. Then it says find a hospital. You have the option to select the region, and then you can select other information based on the region that you select. So I was just going through the app and it's not really intuitive. It doesn't show you what you are supposed to do. You need to figure out a lot of things for yourself. And then I went to report an issue, an environmental issue. Because that day was raining and there were floods, I decided to put in rain. And then I skipped all the personal information, chose submit. I didn't see what happened. There was no notification telling me that, oh, your issue has been reported, you receive a response. You know, an app like this needs to have a place where users can be notified of the actions that they've performed on the app and what action is being taken to address it. When the issue is closed or resolved, the user needs to be notified, then the user can verify. So for example, if a car has blocked the road and I report it, I expect that once it's fixed, they close it on the other side of the app. I'm guessing that the Auditor General has his own app that he can use to resolve issues. And then I can go and confirm if the issue has been fixed indeed on the road. Then I can, you know, write a review or something of the sort. But so far, it's a good concept, it's a good idea, but I think that it's pretty lacking. It's at its infant stages, and there's a lot which can be improved. The UI, the intuitiveness of the app, the possible use cases, and even a social media kind of experience where if somebody reports an issue and someone else reports the same issue within the same geographical area, then the escalation matrix would, you know, keep rising. So if it could move from, it shouldn't go straight to the Auditor General, it should start from the assemblyman in the area. If it moves from the assemblyman, it should go to the MC or DC, whoever. It should go to the MP. If it's not resolved at that level, we can move it to the next higher authority, a minister in charge of that. Then we can even move it to the national level, the vice president and the president level. And we know that as more and more people report the same issue at the same area, then we know that it's a very huge issue, a very serious issue. Potholes, street lights not working, armed robbers, and all these kind of things, you know. So I believe that the app has potential, but it's not there yet. And if anybody knows anybody at the Auditor General's department, they should get in touch with me. I have some ideas that we can share to make this a better app, because I believe in the potential of this app and I want Ghana to succeed, you know. So guys, thank you so much for watching. If you liked this review, click subscribe, like, so that you can see when I do an in-depth review or when I even design a better UI interface and a better user experience for this app, my own version of it, and share with you guys. Thank you so much for watching. See you in the next one. Goodbye.